Hi everybody, today we are going to study angle subtended by an arc of a circle. Okay, now in that first of all we see some properties related to chords and arc. Now if you consider a circle with a center O, and if in this circle there are two chords which are equal, if I consider AB and here CD are the two chords AB is equal to CD, then you can say that the arc AB is equal to arc CD. Okay, and its converse is also true. If the arc AB is equal to arc CD, then the chord AB will be equal to chord CD. Okay. Now here there is a construction. Here we have to join AO and extend up to B. Okay, in each case. Okay, here we have extend AO up to B. Here also we have extend AO up to this B. Okay, now here given is arc PQ subtend angle POQ, that means at a center and at any point it is angle PAQ in each circle. Okay, now in triangle AOP, which triangle? This triangle AOP. In triangle AOP we have OP and OQ are equal, or OA and OQ, sorry, we are considering angle AOP. So in this angle OP and OA are equal. OP is equal to OA, which are radius of circle. Okay, angle this side are equal in each case. Okay, in each triangle also. And here angle OAP is equal to angle APO, because here OA is equal to OP, which are equal sides, so opposite angles are equal. So here we can write angle opposite to equal sides are equal. Okay, angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Now if you consider here, considering AOP triangle, so in triangle AOP here this is our exterior angle. Okay, and these two angles are equal. Okay, now here by exterior angle property which is the exterior angle exterior angle is equal to sum of opposite interior angles. Okay, that means exterior angle, it is a POB, angle POB is equal to which angle? Interior angle OPA plus angle OAP plus APO or P angle APO or OPA. Okay, now here both these angles are equal, so angle POB can be written as angle here OAP plus angle OAP, this angle OAP plus angle OAP, we are considering here both are equal, so which will be equal to angle POP is equal to twice angle OAP. We write it as equation number 1. Okay, we will divide the proof, as in this first part we will prove that this POB, this half of this angle, if you consider this as an half part, so POB is equal to twice of this angle PAO or OAP. In second part we will prove that BOQ will be equal to which angle? Twice of OAQ. Okay, now consider in triangle, AOQ. Okay, now we will consider triangle AOQ triangle. Here again OQ and OA are radius. OQ is equal to OA or radius of circle. Therefore, again by this theorem, angle opposite to equal sides, here you can say that now here these two sides are equal, this side and this side are equal. Now opposite to these two are these angles, this angle OAQ and OQA are equal. So angle OAQ is equal to angle AQO. You can say that angle opposite to equal sides are equal. Okay, now by exterior angle property, here now exterior angle is BOQ, okay, or QOB. So angle BOQ is equal to now opposite angle, sum of opposite angle OAQ and OQA, okay, which are angle OAQ plus angle AQO. Okay, therefore here both are equal, OAQ and AQO are equal, so you can write it as a twice of angle OAQ, angle BOQ. Write it as equation number 2. Okay, now add 1 and 2. So adding left side, here we will get angle OAQ plus angle BOQ is equal to, sorry, here we have written wrong. In equation first, our left is angle POB, angle POB plus angle BOQ is equal to twice of angle OAP plus twice of angle OAQ. Now here angle POB plus BOQ is total angle POQ. So here our left side will become POQ is equal to 2 is common in between, so which is angle OAP plus angle OAQ, which is equal to angle POQ is equal to twice of angle OAP, which angle it is a OAP, and angle OAQ. Addition of these two angles will be equal to PAQ, so which will be twice angle PAQ. Okay, So which is our proof for case first and second? Hence proved for case first and second. That means for semicircle and minor arc, they are equal. You can say that directly, they are equal. Now for case third, here you can write for case three, you have to only write that angle here POQ, because here angle, this POQ, this, if you count this total angle, it is our reflect angle, reflex angle. Okay, so here angle POQ is a reflex, therefore you can write 360 degree minus angle POQ is equal to twice of angle PAQ. Okay, here you have to write, because angle POQ is our reflex angle. Okay, so which is our proof of the theorem number 10.8. okay, so which is important, please write it properly. Now in theorem number 10.9, it is angle in the same segment of the circles are equal. That means if you consider a circle, that means I will consider a circle. Okay, here it is a circle, and segment means when you draw a chord. Okay, there are two parts of circle, which is major segment and minor segment. Okay, now if you draw, the statement says that if you draw an angles in a same segment, that means if we draw a, consider this as a AB chord, and if you draw an angle first, this as a APQ, next this angle as a AQB, or angle here if you consider this third angle ARB, then these three angles are equal. Okay, that means you can say that angle APB is equal to angle AQB is equal to angle ARB. That means they are in the same part of a segment. Okay, so you can say that these three angles are equal. Okay, the statement of the theorem 10 point says that if the angles are in the same segment, that means these three angles are in a same segment, so they are of equal. Okay, next in theorem 10.10, it says that here in theorem, if a line segment joining two points subtend equal angles at the other point lying on the same side of the line containing the line segment, the four point lie on the circle. That means here it is given that if angle P and Q are equal, okay, and if we join to the chords, then this angles these points P, A, B and Q are always lie on a circle only. Okay, it will not be possible that this Q will be exterior or interior part of the circle. Okay, if two angles are equal, angle P is equal to angle Q, then AB, PQ are on the circle, and these four points which lie on the circles is known as a concyclic. Okay, these four points which lie on the circles is known as a concyclic. Okay, next it is a cyclic quadrilateral. Definition of cyclic quadrilateral is all point means this, if you draw a quadrilateral on a circle, that all points of a quadrilateral should be lie on a circle. This type of a quadrilateral is known as a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, understood that? You have to understood that here if you consider A, B, C and D, it is a quadrilateral, and all points of the quadrilateral or vertex of the quadrilaterals are on the circle. So this ABCD is known as a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, next there is a theorem number 10.11, in which the statement is the sum of the either pair of opposite angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degree. That means if you consider this as a cyclic quadrilateral, the opposite pairs angle A plus C is equal to 180 degree, or B plus D is equal to 180 degree. Okay, similarly, if the sum of pair of opposite angles of a quadrilateral is 180 degree, the quadrilateral is cyclic. That means if you consider these angles, opposite angles, its sum is 180 degree, then the quadrilateral is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay? So, these are the theorems related to cyclic quadrilaterals. Okay? Now, we will see examples in our next period. Thank you.